In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to make ChatGPT think outside of the box so that when you're having a long conversation like this one, you can prevent it from going in circles and being too focused on the context and encourage it to think beyond the periphery, to connect the topics that are not connected yet, to think in a way that is more creative. And you can use this approach not only with AI, but also with your own ideas. And in the second part of the video, I'm going to show you how you can also apply it to your own thinking as well, using the main version of InfraNodus, the app that I developed that I'm using in this demonstration as well. Just to give you a quick idea of how it works, here is a conversation I'm having with ChatGPT. It's visualized as a knowledge graph where the words are the nodes and the co-occurrences are the connections. So you can kind of see how AI sees information this way. It's a very simplified way because AI usually uses multidimensional embeddings, but it's kind of the same concept. It's looking at the space and seeing how those concepts are aligned. And then we can build a graph from it and we can see what the structure of this graph is. So for example, here we see that it's quite dispersed. It's focused on creative and prompts, and then the rest of the structure is kind of all over the place a little bit. There's a lot of different topics, but they're not very well integrated. And this is what InfraNodus is telling us, that the diversity of this graph is dispersed, and then it's giving us an advice that we should connect those different clusters a little bit better. So when we click on this advice, we can see some of the topics that we can better connect, that we can bridge, that are not bridged yet. And this is already a way to make ChatGPT think in a way that is more coherent and to avoid it focusing on the stuff that are not relevant, right? So for example, here it says, okay, think of a connection between surrealist art and alternative transportation. These are the two topics that it mentioned, but it didn't really link them well together. So when we ask it to do that, we can click on the bridge button or the question button here, and then it's going to generate a question, which is also a prompt that we can send back to ChatGPT. And then it's going to try to answer that question because it relates to the original conversation, but it will do it in a way that will also make it more coherent, connected better. And then once it's finished answering, the graph will be regenerated and we'll see how it affects the structure. And then gradually we can apply different approaches to see how we can develop this graph further. So for example, if what we just did now was to focus on the gap, we can also do something completely different. We can say, okay, let's focus on some topic at the periphery. Like for example, here, there's one on spaces and hubs and gadgets. So it's at the periphery of the graph and we can ask it to develop it further. And that means that we will go beyond the periphery of the conversation. So as you can see, it can be really helpful to think in this spatial way because you can really quickly see, are the thoughts interconnected or are they too dispersed? If they're too dispersed, InfraNodus will encourage you to connect them. If they're too connected, InfraNodus will encourage you to make them more dispersed. And then, on the other hand, it allows you also to focus on some of the clusters at the periphery. And if you're interested to explore them further, you can use the built-in AI to generate some interesting ideas that can help you think in this direction. This is how we will be using it with ChatGPT as well. So let me show you how it works so you can try it on your own conversation. I will begin from opening a new conversation in ChatGPT and I will use the O1 mini model, but I recommend to use GPT-4 because it's more precise. I will just use mini for the sake of brevity because it's faster. And then I will ask how to make ChatGPT think outside of the box. Please provide some methodologies, no examples. I'm writing no examples and I'm being more specific because usually you will get better results like this. I don't want the examples of the prompts. I rather want the techniques that I can use according to ChatGPT to think it in a way that is more creative. So once the answer is generated, I can then launch the InfraNodus browser extension and then it shows me this conversation as a graph. The words are the nodes. So for example, I can see it's talking about encouraging a model to do something, right? Here, and then I can also see the main topics inside. So for example, here it's talking about creative constraints, outcome mechanisms, diverse perspectives. And then also just by looking at the graph, I can see what's happening with the structure. So here it says that it's quite interconnected. The diversity is optimal. So this is pretty good, but we can definitely improve it by either exploring the different topics and going in more detail or focusing on the gaps between them. So these are the two main approaches that we will use to make ChatGPT think outside of the box or even ourselves. First, to focus on the gaps here. So for example, here I detect some of the topics that could be better connected. Usually it's better if they're further apart from each other on the graph, because as you remember, these are co-occurrences, and if the topics are not connected yet, it means there's an interesting idea that could be generated between them. So here, for instance, there's something about outcome mechanisms and creative constraints. If I click on the context, I can see what are the actual statements in the answer that relate to those topics. And if I want to generate an interesting idea, I can click on AI question, and then it's going to generate a question that will try to link these two topics together. So for example here, how can a structured feedback mechanism incorporating unconventional constraints guide a creative model to progressively explore multiple solutions for complex problem decomposition and varying situations? So actually, it's a really good question to make ChatGPT continue thinking in this direction, because it was talking about structured feedback mechanism and unconventional constraints. So here we're asking exactly that. And then we ask that question, and then it's going to come up with a response. And then in Phronodos, once the response ends regenerating, it's going to regenerate the representation of this conversation. And then we will see what other topics exist out there and what are the main ideas. So for example, now, as you can see, it became focused, maybe even too focused on a specific idea of model and approach and feedback mechanisms. So now it's time to explore beyond the periphery. This is the second approach. If the first approach was to focus on the gaps and try to bridge those gaps, the second approach is to focus on the topics. So you click on the topics here, and then you can choose some of the topical clusters that were identified, and then try to kind of see how you could explore them further. And basically, the way that it works, I'm just going to regenerate the graph so you can see it a little bit better. You will look at the graph, and then you will kind of see what's at the edge of the graph. It means that these are some concepts that are not connected to the central ideas of the conversation. And usually it could be really interesting to explore them further. So for example, as you can see, creative methodology here is on the very edge. And it might be interesting to see how you could develop it further. And it's a little bit like in a normal conversation. You would be talking about some stuff over and over again, but then you touch on one topic that is very, very interesting, and that's kind of like something new in the conversation. Of course, you will be interested to explore it further, especially if it's an interesting one. And here it's exactly the same approach. You would click on this topic, creative methodology. You can see what is the context, so what were the statements that relate to it, and then you can generate a prompt that would make ChatGPT think further in this direction and kind of go beyond the periphery of this graph, of the graph of the conversation, but focusing on this topic. So here it's saying, how can integrating diverse methodologies for promoting creativity enhance ChatGPT's ability to generate unconventional solutions in specific contexts? So that's becoming very interesting, because if we get a good answer to this question, we can even use it in scientific research. So I'm just going to feed it to the model, and then it's going to generate a response. And once the response is generated, then it's going to regenerate the graph and show me what changed. So for example, here it's still focused, but we're exploring a little bit more all those ideas of being a little bit more creative with prompting. Now we're also talking a lot more about solving different problems and using models to solve them, also thinking creatively and so on. So you see the graph is becoming much more diverse, but it also stays interconnected. And this is kind of like a thing that we're trying to achieve. We want to make sure that we cover a lot of different topics, but we also do it in a way that connects to the main ideas. And this is why this kind of visual feedback on the conversation in the form of the graph is very useful, because you can always track what's going on. And if you see that, for example, it's becoming too focused on some ideas, like it's happening here, the advice is to diversify. So it's going to show me that maybe you can remove some of the notes. This is what it's doing. It's removing the central notes first. This is a very interesting approach. It's like we slice off the top layer and get rid of all the most obvious concepts in the conversation, and then it's going to show us what are the topics underneath. So there we can once again apply this approach of either focusing on the gaps, so for example, contextual development, complex solutions, then cognitive strategies. You see the topics are becoming much more specific here. And this is another approach. So first was to focus on the gaps, then go beyond the periphery. The third one now is to cut off the top layer of obvious stuff to see what's hiding underneath. This is very powerful. You can even do it yourself by just clicking on this button here, reveal underlying concepts, and then it's going to slice off the top layer and get to the deeper and more latent topics. So for example, here, iterative exploration, unique perspectives. Let's generate a question based on that. So here it says, how can integrating unconventional constraints within a structured feedback loop enhance the identification and utilization of diverse perspectives to foster innovative solutions in complex problem solving? I mean, this is super interesting because you can even apply it to your own thinking process. So I'm going to copy this into ChatGPT and see what it has to say. So here it's talking about how you can use abstract limitation, resource constraints, perspective shifts, and also how it impacts creativity and how we can also enhance feedback loops. So you see the conversation is becoming very deep. You would never get to this if you just asked ChatGPT how to make it think outside of the box. Now you're really guiding the conversation in the direction that relates to your interests, but also creates an interconnected structure, which is original and that explores both the gaps, the periphery, and that is not too much focused on this surface layer of ideas that everyone is talking about. Because each time you slice off the top layer, you get to the deeper and deeper stuff and you go more and more and more underneath, and then you discover some really interesting concepts there, like that. So this is how you would use it with ChatGPT. I also promised you in the beginning of the video to show you how you can apply the same approach to your own thinking. So you can do this in the main version of Infernodes. Once you go on the main version of Infernodes on infernodes.com, you can go to the apps page, and then what you do is you go into brainstorm ideas, and then you start and you say how to make ChatGPT think outside of the box. Let's just use the same example. And then what you do is you click on AI generated and then on AI ideation mode. This mode allows you to think step by step, so you can sort of control how the responses are made. So here it's going to say, okay, first, prompt it with unexpected interdisciplinary questions or scenarios that blend different fields. Challenge its assumptions or the common patterns and data that it was trained on. So that's an interesting thought. I can add it to the graph. And what's going to happen is that the content that is added is visualized, just like we had it in the previous application in ChatGPT. But here we're doing it step by step. So we have much more control of the thinking process and we will think together with the AI rather than letting it think and then somehow questioning it and guiding it. So here is much more human in the loop approach. And then let's say if I want to kind of develop it a little bit further, I can click on AI chat and then be like, just ask elaborate. And then I will say, focus on this context. So it's going to take this graph structure and then try to generate some interesting insights that I can then add into the graph and continue moving on. So for example, here it says, introduce scenarios where typical boundaries of knowledge don't apply, merging art with science or technology with philosophy, for instance, to push beyond usual data-driven responses. That's a great answer also. I'm going to visualize it. And then I can go into the chat mode and then it says, okay, so select a node. So for example, I will choose scenario, data, instance, and maybe boundary. So as you can see, I'm kind of selecting the graph structure that I want to develop further, and then I can ask it to generate some idea based on it. But because I'm relating it to the original context of the conversation, it's always going to be related to the original subject here. So here it says, in the scenario where the boundary between instance and data blurs, we navigate through fluid landscapes of knowledge, redefining limits by intertwining empirical data with experiential instances. This is very interesting because it's telling me, okay, if you want to think more creatively or if you want to make ChatGPT think more creatively, try not to only focus on data, but also on how it feels like, because this is not the actual data it's used to. And as you can see, I just added this here, and now those nodes are much more interconnected. So this is how I'm kind of bridging gaps here, exactly the same thing that I was doing here, where I was bridging the gaps in this more dense graph, right? Here I'm doing the same by just focusing on the node. So it's exactly the same approach. And just like in the previous example, I can also go into topics here and I can say, okay, let's explore the periphery. So for example, here, knowledge fusion or empirical boundaries. Let's say knowledge fusion. This is at the periphery of the graph. I want to develop it further. So I select this topic and then I click on AI insights. I will select it again and then I will ask it to generate a response that relates to this topic. And here it's kind of exploring this in a little bit more detail. And I click save to graph. And as you can see, this topic now becomes much more developed. So this is the approach that you use. And this is why it's very nice to have this graph visualization, because it allows you to see what's actually going on the structural level, that if you want to think outside of the box, you can focus on the peripheral topics and develop them further. You can focus on gaps, or like we had in this previous approach, we can slice off the top layer of the most influential nodes, like here, data, boundary, scenario. We remove them, we hide them, and then the things that are underneath, they pop up much more. So for example, we can see here, there's interdisciplinary challenges and maybe blending assumptions, and then we can focus on that more and then generate a response. And it's exactly the same approach. You slice off the top layer, you kind of pretend like you don't want to talk about the main ideas anymore, you get to the more specific ones, and then you develop them further. Once you've done that, you add them into the conversation, and then you can always zoom out, you know, and see how it affected the general structure. Usually it will become much more diverse and much richer. In fact, if you want to read more about this approach, you can go to infranodus.com here, and we have a section in the About Us on cognitive variability, and this whole approach is kind of explained there, how it works step by step, with some links to more details and also the concept of ecological thinking. So there is this chart here that shows that it's about disrupting ideas and connecting them, focusing and exploring, diversifying, focusing, and then getting rid of the stuff that you don't need and zooming in again on a specific topic to develop it further. So it's this kind of like iterative approach that goes in cycles, but that allows you to combine zooming in with zooming out, focusing with exploring, and based on this approach, you can really create a very diverse set of ideas, and that can be very useful if you're doing research, if you're thinking about a certain topic, or also for marketing applications as well, because you want to think in the ways that others are not, and this can be a really useful tool for that. So feel free to try it out on infranodus.com, where you can get an account and then download the extension. If you have any questions, please let me know. And also, I have another channel where I will soon post a video with more detailed instructions on how you can do this step by step. So if you're interested, also subscribe to this other channel so you can get informed when the video is out. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments to the video below, and I will be happy to respond. Thank you.